Hi friends, welcome to chapter 10 of 5G and our physical layer concepts. In this chapter, we will discuss about the antenna ports and concept of quasi co-location. We will also understand the difference between antenna ports and a physical antenna. So let's start. Let's first talk about antenna ports. Downlink multi-antenna transmission is a key technology of NR. And signals transmitted from different antenna ports will experience different radio channels, even if the set of antennas are located at the same site. Meaning to say that a wireless communication channel is usually modeled by a coefficient H. If we study a wireless communication channel, we usually model that as Y equals to HX, where X is the input and Y is the output. So that H coefficients represents the channel, wireless channel. So if the signals are transmitted from different antenna ports, that H coefficient will be different. Otherwise, if the signal is transmitted from same antenna port, that H coefficient for both the signals will be same. In some cases, it is important that the transmission share the same antenna port. Let's take an example that PDSCH physical channel and PDSCH DMRS share the same antenna port because it helps the UE to estimate the channel using DMRS and use that channel information in decoding information content on the PDSCH. But MIMO takes advantage of this property, actually, property of having different radio channel across different antenna ports to transmit multiple parallel streams of data. So actually it is a kind of diversity. So let's take an example that when we are transmitting over multiple antennas, so not all antenna will experience bad conditions on channel. At least one antenna will have a good channel, or one receive and transmit antenna pair will have a good channel. So we can transmit information successfully. Now let's understand what actually is antenna port and what actually is physical antenna. Are they same or are they different? So it is important to understand that antenna port is an abstract concept. It's not a real thing, a real world thing. So there is a difference in logical antenna port and physical antenna element. Okay. So specific transmissions use specific antenna ports, and then those antenna ports are mapped onto one or more physical antenna elements. Okay. So the entity which is actually transmitting the signal is the physical antenna. But abstractically it is antenna port, and there is a mapping between antenna port and physical antenna. So that mapping can be one to one or one to many. So as an example, the synchronization signals, the PBCH and the PBCH DMRS use antenna port 4000. That is, all three transmissions share the same antenna port. So as already discussed, that multiple transmission can be done using same antenna port or different antenna port. Okay, and talking of mapping between antenna port and physical antenna, it can be one-to-one mapping or one-to-many mapping. One-to-one mapping is useful when operating in lower frequencies. So this is an important concept actually. One-to-one mapping is useful when we are operating in lower frequency bands, because there we do not require beamforming. Fine. In higher frequency bands, we actually require beamforming, because in higher frequency bands, losses or path loss is more than the lower frequency band. So to compensate for that path loss, we actually need beamforming. Okay. And beamforming requires multiple physical antenna elements. Fine. So one-to-one mapping is usually required in lower frequency bands, and one-to-many mapping is usually required in higher frequency bands for beamforming. Let's understand mapping with the help of examples. We'll first understand one-to-one example. We take a 2x2 MIMO case with antenna port 1000 and 1001. So antenna port 1000 is mapped onto one physical antenna, while antenna port 1001 is mapped onto other physical antenna. So as we can see here, these blue and red are two different physical antennas. Okay. And antenna content of antenna port 1000 is mapped onto one antenna, one physical antenna, while content of antenna port 1001 is mapped onto another physical antenna. Fine. So from the UE perspective, there are two downlink transmissions, one PDSCH and DMRS on 1000 on antenna port 1000, while another PDSCH and its DMRS on antenna port 1001. Fine. But UE does not actually require the knowledge of which physical antenna elements were used for transmission or what were their mappings. For UE perspective, they are still the same antenna port. UE still have the knowledge of, or UE still have the concept of antenna port only. UE does not have any knowledge or any concept of physical antenna related to it. They only, UE is only aware of, about the antenna port. Now there is another example where there is a single antenna port, but it is mapped onto two different physical antennas. Okay, so there is a one-to-many mapping between antenna port and physical antenna element. So this obviously, as discussed earlier, that this may be done when using the higher operating bands which require beamforming, because here beamforming can be done. So beamforming actually uses multiple physical antenna elements to direct the downlink transmission towards a specific UE. Okay, so this is typically achieved using an antenna array consisting of multiple columns of cross polar antennas. Okay, so this was about beamforming, but what is happening among antenna port and physical antenna, that the content of single antenna port is mapped onto multiple physical antennas. But as we already understand that UE does not have any concept or any knowledge of physical antenna, it only understand about the antenna port. So it doesn't matter how many physical antennas are in use. From the UE perspective, there is still one, and there is still single antenna port. Okay. Now let's understand another case where there are multiple antenna ports, and but those antenna ports are mapped onto multiple physical antennas. Okay. So content of antenna port 1000 is mapped onto two physical antennas. Similarly, content of antenna port 1001 is mapped onto two physical antennas. Fine. So, but from the UE perspective, still there are antenna ports. Still there are two antenna ports. So this example is, if we look from the UE perspective, this example is actually similar to the first example, where each antenna port has one-to-one mapping to the physical antennas. Here each antenna port has one-to-many mapping. Okay, so from the mapping point of view, they are different, but from the UE perspective, they are actually same. So the difference comes in the case that here actually we can do the beamforming. Okay, so here beamforming can actually help to improve the link budget, and it is transparent to the UE, because that is, the UE does not require any explicit knowledge of the beamforming at the base station. Okay, so the point to understand here is that if we look from the UE perspective, this example and the first example where there was one-to-one mapping between antenna port and physical antenna are actually similar, but if you look from the beamforming point of view, this actually provides some gain in the link budget. Okay. Now let's talk about the concept of antenna quasi co-location. So far we have understood that transmission sharing the same antenna port experience the same radio channel, while transmission using different antenna ports experience different radio channels. Fine. But there are scenarios where transmissions using different antenna ports experience same radio channels or similar radio channels, which share common characteristics. Okay, so different antenna ports but same radio channel. In this case, the antenna ports are said to be quasi co-located, abbreviated as QCL. So the radio channel characteristics, which may be common across different antenna ports because of quasi co-location, includes Doppler shift, Doppler spread, average delay, delay spread, spatial receiver parameters. Okay, So these are known as large scale radio channel characteristics. In contrast, antenna ports are always assumed to have different small scale radio channel characteristics, that is different fast fading. Okay, so they are actually differs in large scale radio channel characteristic and small scale radio channel characteristics. So 3GPP introduced the concept of quasi collocation to help the UE with its channel estimation, frequency offset estimation and synchronization procedures. How? For example, if two antenna ports are characterized as being QCL or quasi collocated in terms of delay spread, then the UE can actually determine the delay spread for one antenna port only and then apply the similar result or the same result to both antenna ports. Okay, so in this way, computational effort can be reduced. This avoids the UE having to determine the delay spread separately for each antenna port, obviously. So quasi-collocated antenna ports may be geographically separated. It may happen. It may be possible. 3GPP has specified four types of quasi-collocation to indicate which large-scale channel characteristics are common across the set of QCL antenna ports. So these four types of QCL are labeled A, B, C, and D. So actually the categorizations of QCL are based on what type of large scale channel characteristics are common. Okay, so the type A are having Doppler shift, Doppler spread, average delay and delay spread as common. Type B, Doppler shift, Doppler spread. Type C, Doppler shift, average delay. And type D, spatial receiver parameters. Fine. Now talking of antenna ports, this table actually summarizes the set of 5G antenna ports standardized by 3GPP. So synchronization signals and PBCS DMRS for PBCH actually have the antenna port they use is 4000. So you can actually see what channel or what signal is actually using which antenna port. Okay. I would like to thank all my viewers who have supported me till now. I would request them to post their queries if they have any in the comment section. And also please share these videos, this particular video and the previous videos which I have posted, with their colleagues and friends so that they increase the knowledge about 5G. And please subscribe to this channel for more 5G NR lectures. Thank you.